Welcome back, everybody, here to your coverage of the MSI Beta to 2014. Remember the year, global competition. Let's get into the game. It's game number three of HCT going up against VG Gaming in our winner's bracket semi-final matchup. The winner of this will face up against LGD CDEC in the grand, the winner's bracket final. And then, hey, who knows, if you can get the grand final and you win that one, you go to Taiwan to battle it out for the lion's share of $50,000 courtesy of MSI. So, great Dota all around. LAN events, wonderful. Travel, beautiful. If you're also going to be in Taiwan, Don Capitalist will be there, as well as Zoe. Zoe, Cap, as well as Melk will be the three people. We're flying down to Taiwan to cover that event live. I'll be over in, actually, Bucharest during that time, as we have both DreamHack as well as the MSI Beat at LAN Finals all on at the same time. It's going to be a big, big weekend of Dota then. So that's going to be roughly, I think, a month and a half away. I think it is. We have 3 weeks till New York. It's 3 weeks till New York. It's crazy. It's really, really crazy. So, yeah, that's coming up. We have ESL 1 games as well. Tomorrow night, we're probably actually going to have three ESL games all at the same time. Not all at the same time, just a little bit more spaced out. All right. 5 seconds draft remaining. Time. Draft time is underway. Hey, HCT, why you do this to me, SMJ?
VG
not happy. Not bad. Happy. Banning Drum in the first set again. First time, forgivable. Second time, blasphemy. I'll also ban out the Lycan. The Wisp again. Just won't let it through. And we're looking at a very, very similar draft.
10 seconds remaining.
The only difference is the Viper is now over on HCT.
Five seconds.
It won't be the hands of Super for this game. But Skywrath Mage and Centaur, a very standard opening first two pickup. It's your initiation, it's your lane control. Don't really need much more apart from that. The Viper and the Death Prophet also. A little bit more standard, but considering you're not getting your combo straight away, and the combo is also not being banned out. They can still run an offlane Faceless Void. Pick. Viper safe lane, Death Prophet mid. And it's going to be Dorska.
VG Gaming's turn to pick.
Coming up is the third pick up here for HGT. A very, very favorite hero of mine. And a Sandkin from VG. Pick. Well, Fenrir, last time I saw this guy play an SK, like, it was, like, one word. Sploosh. It was wonderful. It was absolutely wonderful to see. I've seen triple quad Barrow strikes, evasions with Sandstorm. The epicenters weren't even required because they got killed so quickly. It was a wonderful, wonderful sight to behold. And with him and Centaur both getting blink daggers early,
remaining.
It's going to be rough for HCT, which means they could try and find a way to counter that up by moving into the enemy jungle. That means some heavy warding. Block up as many of the camps as possible. And try it that way. But it's up to them. Do they really want to go in there with a Tuskar? They need something else. Because they don't really have like an instant follow-up. Like a Death Prophet ultimate. You can hold him inside the ball.
Disruptor.
But...
Gaming's turn to pick.
So it's... I can see the control. I can see the teamfight control. But I don't see the lane control at all. And I don't see a plan B. If it doesn't work, like this Tuskar and Disruptor. Disruptor's not a roaming ganker. He's not going to go with the Tuskar. And with the SK and the Skywrath Mage, their roaming ganker gets so much more effective.
5 seconds remaining.
This Disruptor pickup, I just don't see how it's going to work. If you're trying to find a way to stop the Stampede, then get a Rubick. Like a Rubick would work with the Tuskar. It's more control, it's more AoE control as well as having burst damage, which allows you to get the kill and move on to the next. That's the whole idea about the roaming ganking. Now, the Disruptor is great for lane control, and that's basically it. You could try and run something else, like a Lich plus Mirana offlane. So you do a dual lane offlane, put the Viper on the safe lane with the Disruptor and then the Death Prophet in mid. Then I would be down with. That's actually the combination which we saw coming out from MMY and crew. LGDCM were running that one. I'm not going to say the exact lineup, but it's just the dual lane. But I'm really, at this point, not 100% certain about the Disruptor pickup. We'll see how well it pans out. I think VG Gaming aren't 100% sure about this either. If they were planning, like, Quop, Storms, Pucks, they're probably thinking twice about that, and they just go for... All right, that's gonna... Actually, it could go either way. Black has actually played a lot of Slark. Back when you're still playing in European Dota, he played a lot of Slark. And IceIceIce also enjoys playing the Slark. And it's the same for the Centaur. So that's very interchangeable. It just depends if they want to run on the safe lane or the off lane. If they run on the off lane, I'm fairly certain IceIceIce would prefer to have that. So they can run Slark, SK, Skywrath. I'm normally not a big advocate of running the dual melees, but when you're going up against a melee support anyway, and technically you've got Pounce as well as Burrow Strike, so you've got two ways where you can get yourself in close anyway with the Skywrath Mage, it might just be too good to bypass. The other option is you work out, like, we've got one more here from HGT. So just see where the lanes are and then you look towards your own. The only thing I'd be worried about is more silences onto the Slark. You've only got one, if you include the Eye of the Storm. Oh, sorry, Static Storm. Eye of the Storm is Razor. That's Static Storm. Yeah. Whoops. Speaking of Razor, not selected yet. Not a hero you want in this game. Not here you want. Unless you're VG Gaming, at which point then it will be potentially there. And Ember Spirit's going to be their ban out. Worry too much about like that range controller. So now the fifth ban to come up from VG Gaming.
10 seconds remaining.
Who do they look at? Who are they even worried about in this? And they just profit. All right, so they just remove a little bit of the split push. Their lineup can deal with that quite well. Once you get a Blink Dagger over on the Slark, and he has Shadow Dance, you're able to run yourself across the map very, very quickly. It only takes like 20 seconds to get from one end to the other, as long as you don't go, as long as you don't get in vision. It's a very, very quick run. But hey, HGT, last selection now. So what's going to be the final core here? So that's going to be the Tusker, and we get ourselves a different support hero. Nope. Faceless Void will be the selection. And I'm liking this draft even less, and I'm liking it even less now. That's a perfect final pickup for the last hero. The Omni Knight selection comes up. Now, why this is so damn good against HGT's lineup is primarily because HGT, you get Chrono Lockdown, you get Tuskar coming in close. The Death Prophet wants to try and stay as close as she possibly can, and even if she doesn't want to be, they will be. The Centaur jumps in, the SK jumps in, the Slark jumps in, the Omni Knight just purifies it. So heals up your own hero, which you're already getting a lot of life points healing up for the Slark when he goes inside the Shadow Dance, but you can double heal. And then you've got the Centaur as well. Chugga. Is Chugga going to stop? Is Chugga stopping? Chugga is not stopping. All right, we reconnect. But basically, you trigger the Faceless Void Chrono, and even Void wants to run in there. So he's going to get purified, because the target which is being attacked will be purified. And then on top of that, you got the Mystic Flare, which will also drop, which will force him off the lane. Force him out of the Chrono. Not completely, just off the hero. And if he doesn't, he takes a huge chunk of damage. So going for like a PMS Treads as well as Mask of Madness build is going to be really difficult for him to try and capitalize on. Unless he's able to catch the Skywrath Mage inside of the Chrono. That's the only other way around that. Alright, right now I'm very, 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 very concerned for HGT's lineup. But we'll see if I'm going to be proved right or wrong. As it looks like our jumping is still going to continue. I apologize to everyone inside of Dota TV. This is going to cause some... Actually, are we smoothing? Are we smoothing? I think we're smoothing. Oh, silky smooth, boys. Not completely, but we're at a point where I think we can stay inside the game. I was a little bit worried we'll have to jump ourselves out to Dota TV. Alright, but in we go. Oh, a little bit of Ice Shards, just holding FY away from the Haste Rune. If he's good enough, he could come out for a denial. There's no Observer Wards from the Dire side watching for his... Oh! Ooh! The attack came from the middle of nowhere, just came out of the trees like, what? No. And he'll grab the Haste Rune. So, aggro tri-lane from HGT. They'd run SMJ, they'd run a Tuskar with little Haste Rune. as well as SS the Disruptor, going up against the VG Gaming lineup of FY, Fenrir, and Black. So it will be the Slark on the safe lane. Maybe not the greatest hero they wanted up in this matchup. They probably would have preferred to actually have the Centaur down here. But because Black doesn't really fare too well up against the Viper, seeing already being harassed back. And the Centaur up against the Void. Actually, that's not a bad matchup for... I'm going to say the Centaur at this point, considering Icy. At any point, he could just get brought down. And if he's got some luck with the backtrack, maybe he might survive. Beyond that, probably not. The Omni Knight goes in towards the middle lane. It's the more favored position. We saw it earlier today. That's what I was flagging for. It was Light Gaming who ran it in a match earlier today. And they ran a 3 points purification, 2 points degen aura. You walk in close, you get your hit off. That was the goal. In this game, fairly certain it's looking pretty similar. 7-1 up against a 5-0. Not even controlling up Super's farm. The bottle is already on its way in towards that mid lane. And up on the top lane, Ice 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 versus Icy. Sometimes there's irony. Fenrir, wait for it. He's looking for the double Burrow Strike. Right now he's just waiting for his time. There goes your Burrow Strike into Pretty Whore, but it's not going to be enough space. The Skywrath Mage will still go down. They kind of need to be like a semi-body block as well as the Burrow Strike, but Fenrir just couldn't find the right angle for it. Like he was really hoping to catch out too just then, but the early damage from a Thunderstrike makes life very, very difficult, especially when it's already started off with the Ice Shards from Pretty Whore. I think you might have also been a little bit more concerned the Snowball was going to be coming. So if the Snowball was going to come, and he just Burrow Striked, he would waste his Snowball. That is his Burrow Strike. Which means HGT could turn one kill into two. So it's a good start to the offlane of HGT. The Viper's getting some really good farm. The Slark is completely shut down. 1-0. Like, completely shut down. Fenrir, Burrow Strikes the other side of the Ice Shards. A little bit of waste of mana for him, but he had no other choice or else he would have died. As a DD rune into the hands of the Disruptor. And because they did the pull, they knew they'd be in jeopardy anyway. So for now, HGT, a good start, good money, a lot of good money, in fact. They're shutting down the lane farm. Even up on top lane, VG Gaming going to pause it. Is Ice 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 having some problems here? He seems to be very far out of position. A good couple of time locks. And he may even go down. Because you've also got leap, so a simple hoof stomp wouldn't be enough to escape from this. And now, oh, there goes your hoof stomp. Time walk. Yep, he's going to leap. Time lock on the first hit. Second, no. Third, no. And you're back up after coming in range of the tower. One of the attacks, he actually manages to backtrack himself. So still 1-0. Ice 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 way too injured on this offlane. He wants to get to his Tranquil Boots. He's managed to purchase them, but the courier is currently busy. He's going to fly north to start with. It's got Super's Bottle on the back of it too. And he needs that to come back towards mid lane and pretty quick. The Death Prophet still winning on the CS here. And this whole purification build's only going to keep working as long as he's got mana to play with. And he doesn't want to use it too close towards the creep wave like this. He wants to do it when he's right next to the hero. There's now Faceless Void. Why did you... Don't know why Ice 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 hung around as long as he did. That gives a solo kill to the Faceless Void. That gives Icy his level 6. This would be more critical if he actually TP's the bottom lane right now. If he goes... Okay, you push the lane up on the top. You're going to get forced back anyway. You munch on your tango, you buy a TP scroll, you head bottom lane, and you trigger off your ultimate. You catch two heroes. Primarily one you're searching for is Black. And then ZSMJ just attacks him from range. He's only level 4, which isn't that great. That's all you really need. Now, is VG Gaming really resorting to a level 1 Sandstorm to try and zone out HGT? It's not really a healthy thing for Fenrir to actually do, considering every time that Sandstorm will connect into the Skywrath Mage, it ends up triggering his Corrosive Skin, which is now also up at level 2, instead of having the 2 points up in Poison, which I thought he might. FY is coming in, trying to keep it secret, but he's most definitely being watched. The Dire Observer was seeing him perfectly. And I think Ice 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 just picked it out saying, yo man, fairly certainly got vision there. It's like Fenrir. He's got him, he was looking to do a triple stack. But there was some movement coming over from the Tusker. Now there's more movement coming out from him. The sigil, they're searching for Black in the tree line. Poor little Slark with only 4 CS, getting no momentum whatsoever, and now gonna get poisoned up. He's gonna leap himself over the tree line to try and get himself away. And I thought for a moment he might try and go for the glimpse. The snowball protects him, but then the dark pack. Large amount of damage going into the disruptor. He does go down. The Slark gets the joy of the kill. Took a little bit longer to attack. The Slark, of course, because he obviously had the frozen sigil on top of you. But it still ends up being a one-for-one trade-off. Unfortunately for the Slark, he ended up dying before the kill. So he doesn't get any of the extra money for it all. Any of the extra experience. Well, Fenrir is at least able to grab some of this from outside the jungle. Pretty horse him fairly close. He's actually leeching a little bit of the experience here. If he took a little bit more damage, then ice shard farming. Oh, now they got him. Burrow strike and just purify. Little bit of a right click and Omni Knight will take the last hit. So 2-3 on the board. Good rotation now from the Omni Knight.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Well, that's the first kill they've actually got experience for. The only other one they claimed was Slark getting the disruptor on the bottom lane only moments ago. But they also lost the tier one tower in the bottom lane for this. So that kill doesn't really bring up the advantage. It's 4,000 gold going the way of HGT. The experience starting to level up a little bit more. But definitely that tier one tower going down has helped the pockets of HGT. Fenrir still desperately trying to farm up this money too. Not to mention the levels. He wants the level 2 Burrow Strike, a level 3 Burrow Strike, which means he needs level 5. Watching Pretty Whore as well as disruptor walk in. Black just walked into it too. He's going to actually get this Dark Pact off and pounce himself away, but the pounce is currently on cooldown. And they lock him down. Another death going the way of the Slark. Now we're second for the game. Support on top lane. Chrono going to be committed on ice, and there's nothing FY can do about it. Actually, he can steal up and then turn into the attack with the double edge. Ice, holding himself away. Maybe there's a leap away in time. He's backtracking out the damage from FY. And now they're going to turn themselves over to ZSMJ. Viper's killed off the Centaur in the meantime. But ZSMJ will go down as the Omni Knight came in to help out. Kaka in through the rear. And FY able to TP himself out in time. Super not looking so healthy. Phase Boots. He's already used all of his one charges and needs exorcism just right behind him. And he's able to run himself out. Look at those legs pump. Look at those little legs pump. This guy's a natural born sprinter. The power of game compels you to move faster. But that's 3-5 now on the board. The exorcism was triggered. Not to push down the tower, however. Which is a good thing for VG Gaming, because that means they're not losing as much map control as they could potentially. And the fact that Centaur just tanked up the entire chrono time just shows you too that how much damage this Faceless Void does. He went minus to start with though, so he will definitely be dealing out a lot of damage later on. Pretty Horse just leeching the experience at the moment. He's pinging out the fact that Fenrir is here, and Fenrir has now just realized, yep, okay, well, Mud Golems. I'll leave them there for someone else to farm up, because my Sandstorm has no effect on them whatsoever. Looking towards mid lane, Super to the front lines. Disruptor as well as Tuskar is here. Both sides very much aware of each other's existence. Now the Ice Shard, Super, already starts walking back the other direction to make sure that he doesn't get caught deep inside the shards. Ice TPing out, the Viper Strike connected on him. It's not enough damage to kill him, he'll regenerate inside the fountain. But a smart quick TP out from him. They're going in deeper now. Fenrir searching for a way. 3 points in, actually, he's got 3 points up in the Sandstorm. He can stay close enough to get this experience with the last point. Either that or... okay. Just start farming instead. Maybe he wants his Blink Dagger before he gives it a shot. But he definitely wants that third point up in the Burrow Strike. Maybe even before he picks up his Epicenter. Because there's still a lot of ways that he can get cancelled on that Epicenter. Even later into the game, the glimpse is going to cause him some problems. When he thinks he's going to be in a really good position, just a blink Burrow Strike and throw the Epi out, you still get at least 2 pulses off before you get glimpsed away. Fenrir trapped in the wall. He's got Sandstorm, however. They have Dust, they have Sentries, they've got 2 Sentries. As Fenrir definitely copying a lot of that harassment already. But the Exorcism most of the time has been wasted. The mid tower is still only half life points. I know we're only like 10 minutes into the game, but right now the more important thing is just going to be these levels. The towers are I'm like, meh. VG Gaming are all about their teamfight control and initiation. When that comes up, when you get that blink dagger over on the centaur, then it's all about VG Gaming's momentum. HCT are all about forcing the towers early on and ensuring if there is ever going to be a team fight from VG Gaming, it's 5v5, not 3v2 or 3v1. If that's the kind of stuff like currently on it is on bottom lane, they'll lose these fights one after the other. And Centaur ulti's now going to be triggered. I think that's so he can escape on the top lane, but the Snowball chasing him down. The wall already went in super. Going to TP in. Purification hurts the Taskar, especially when they're able to trigger off that Omni-Knight ultimate as well. Protection galore. The Taskar goes down. And the disruption wall is up. After they realize the Faceless Void also TP'd off the bottom lane. Black goes back into his farming. Build a recovery Midas on this Slark. I know it's only 11 minutes in, but still. Slark should have a lot more momentum than this, so this is a recovery.
Bottom tower is under attack.
So, Sigil being picked off, the fortification as well. And Geist just wants time to farm up more than anything else. He needs the time for the Blink Dagger. Black's also creep skipping it out so he can get his own. And the tower's gone. They were always going to lose this, the Glimpse. Sends nowhere.
Bottom tower is under attack.
It really hasn't been his Knight S on that Disruptor. From the last game to this game, it's just been a very, very rough day. So Centaur, closer and closer to having that Blink Dagger. This really is VG Gaming's clutch moment if they can use it, but at the same time, ZSMJ is now able to finish up a mech. So he's got a lot of survivability coming up from him. Yeah, the Faceless Void already with his Hand of Midas. And where the hell is... Didn't Black buy a... Where is your Midas? Did he sell his Midas?
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Was I tripping? People in the chat, please help me here. I don't know what the hell he did with his Hand of Midas. Someone tweet me, W1 Dota, what the hell happened to his Midas? I thought he went for that. Maybe he sold it straight away. I only saw it appear on the side. Alright, middle lane, Kaka. Gonna push your Scepter. Orb stop, not in time. That Mystic Flare, though, really burning into the Faceless Void. That Navara strike out from Fenrir. He's out a little way, but the Centaur's already low and light. The Polar Punch going into Fenrir. He's on the sidelines. Black with the Dark Pack breaks free. Well, he'll be glimpsed straight back in the engagement, but Purification allowing Black to dish out a lot of damage. The Shadow Dance gave him some cover fire. He's got 9 wand charges. He'll have to use them all right now. There's a body blocking from Pretty Hawk. Perfectly in position. And the T1 tower will drop down. HGT push their advantage harder. 8-5 now on the board. I think the answer was I'm tripping. Alright, so that's not a great fight for VG Gaming. They're losing more and more momentum. The next Exorcism should probably be used to kill off Roshan. It is up at level 1 still right now. So the injection of experience will also be nice. As the Blink Dagger finally arrives for Fenrir. I'm seriously going to look back through the replay just to make sure. Because I'm not sure. I'm not sure at all. Ice, leap, Chrono. Perfectly held in position. And ZSMJ, he's the one to get the kill out of this one. He threw the Viper Strike as well as all the poison he had. He's only got 1 point up with the Nether Toxin, but he's only a level 9 Viper, so it's completely understandable. Bottom lane, they're coming in for Kaka. And they got him. Fire Strike, Purification heal. The Yule Scepter will send him up, but the Sandstorm almost in range. Black trying to pounce and Dark Pack, goes into the Shadow Dance. He needs more speed. But Kaka, phase boost. He's going to outrun him. Fire Strike, too short. Kaka is away. He's on the break. And it's like, oh! This is just, it's salt in the wound. That's what it is. It's salt in VG Gaming's wound. The last 3 engagements they ended up having against HGT. They are so far behind in net worth now. Yeah, the gold is now at 7,500. The experience is as she shot back up again, but then fell as fast as it rose. And now they're looking for Black. A little bit more difficult to catch him out. They can't hear the chrono off cooldown again. In comes Roshan. There is the double damage room for Viper. Taking a little bit too long for it, but as I said, the next exorcism is meant to be for Roshan. They need the Aegis the Immortal before they can feel confident enough to try and push into the tier 2 towers. You gotta remember, we're still only 15 minutes into the game, and the team fight initiation of VG Gaming is still quite strong. So they have to keep this in mind.
Roshan has
so there's Roshan now going the way of HGT. The Viper is the man who gets to hold on to the immortality. With no Death Prophet ulti, they don't really want to force the issue at all right now. In fact, they should be backing up as opposed to having this happen. Pretty Hall getting picked off. Wait, finish the job! Now the silence comes in. The Glimpse going to drag Ice back, but at the same time, Mystic Flare almost burning out that Disruptor. But the Chrono from Icy bought enough space until the Omniite ulti. That's what this is all about, to get yourself in and out of that Chrono with minimal damage and the Hoof Stomp. It's going to connect on the Faceless Void. They need to bring him down. He actually managed to backtrack out of the Double Edge, allowing him now to leap himself away and away from the damage required to kill him. Fenrir, Repel won't save him, and the Glimpse back on top of Super. Degen Aura applying to all of HGT at the moment, while the Purification, there's Ice coming in finally to finish the job, but the Shards will hold him in position, not to mention kill him off, while the leap away, 6 life points and 9 mana on a Faceless Void. What is this? Yule Scepter, Skyrath, can't even get out. FY is gone, 4 heroes on the sideline. The exorcism wasn't even used. They will push this tier 2 tower. They will take this tier 2 tower.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
So the tier 2 tower is gone. Support's coming back. Oh, actually, it's not. They use fortification. And they're still short the mana for the exorcism. Now they get it. Some arcane boots being triggered. Speaking of which, look at the point booster already. Rushing the Aghanim Scepter, wants to stop these items from being used. Slark, no Blink Dagger for him, just has to go into the drums. There's no other way Black is capable of fighting right now. He had to go for like the tier 1 upgrade item, as opposed to going into the tier 3s. Ice with a smoke, he's trying to have a crack here at Icy. 1 second until you've got that ultimate Mystic Flare, gonna have to burn him quickly, Steal as well. And they got it. The Centaur ulti was triggered just in case there wasn't enough. And that shows you just how desperate VG Gaming are for kills. In most other situations, Ice would have never done such a thing. But he needed to ensure that Faceless Void died. So 30 seconds on the sideline. No buyback available as he's now trying to go into a Diffuser Blade. So Faceless Void is the way to get around that repel. It's SMJ feeding into Ice, Viper Strike, and he's just out. Oh, Glimpse! He's in trouble. Hoof Stomp. He's looking for a double edge denial. Nope. Not gonna happen. So Ice ends up going down. Black trying to force this bottom tower. He does still have Shadow Dance. But it's Kaka, the man to TP him. The tower is now within deny range. Black won't want to back up from this. This is free money which he wants to take. You have to wait for the creep wave to pass him. Or he could just attack right now and run the risk of dying to a Death Prophet. Especially as Faceless Void's already on the way down to the bottom lane. Yes, you can't deny with Double Edge. I don't know why I even friggin' said that. Leap out from Faceless Void. It's been a long few days. Pretty Hill now gonna find Super in the tree line. The Sigil not gonna be happy. The Repel's already gonna go off. The Leap Out. Chrono is available. He doesn't really want to trigger it for this, however. If he can catch multiple heroes, he'll do it. And now, holding Super. They have the high ground here, HGT. The wall's up, and then a big Hoof Stomp sent up in towards the air. The Mystic Flare trying to hold him with the Snowball. Protection, in fact, takes him down the hill into Super. The Burrow Strike from Fenrir catching them all. Gonna go into the Epicenter and dig it off in time, but the damage is not enough. The Mech Charges are already hitting. While the glimpsing away of Black, taking him out of this fight and letting the Exorcism do the work. 3 heroes down so far. Disruptor will finally go down. Super bringing him down. while the pounce out from Black couldn't get the leash over to Icy to try and juke him up through the tree line. While the Exorcism hitting into Super, able to regenerate himself up for the moment, now with his ultimate, giving him some protection. He's not the only man surviving, Black is here with him. It's going to take a lot of work to get back on top of this. Then again, Black, now the vision's still up on top of the hill, so he's not getting the movement speed up on top of, on the hill to catch up to get the pounce onto Kaka. Even if he did, there'll still be that Yule Scepter to protect him for a little bit longer, but then that would have allowed Super to come in range. So no team wipe, which is what HGT were looking for, and it looked like they were going to get it. Fenrir's control, when they all snowballed in, that's that older moment where you're like, okay, this is the reason why we don't pick up Tuskar, because we put everybody into position for the perfect AoE stuns. Ice in the meantime. This guy needs some regeneration and badly. He needs his cloak. It's what he needs. He needs to get the cloak and then get into the Hood of Defiance as early as he possibly can. I know he's going up against a lot of physical damage, but he just needs it so he can survive himself. Well, Super here in the middle lane. Looks like we're trying to go for the full Aghanim's upgrade, which means that Diffuser Blade won't be able to help you out. Black, where's your glimpse? Drag him in, Burrow Strike into ZSMJ. Large amount of damage, but purification as well as the Dark Pact being used. And Black had to use Shadow Dance as well, just in case there was any kind of follow-up. But he'll go up to the top lane, soak up the experience as well as the farm. While on bottom lane, Ice, keeping this push going as quick as he can. He'll have to basically hoof stomp and double edge it. Either that, or they accept the fact they'll lose this tier 2 tower in mid. Every ulti is up for HGT. And they're all coming in. The Observer Ward's for vision around the side, seeing if anyone's trying to get a little bit of a flank going up through this direction. Radiant's middle tower, and the Exorcism will be used from very, very, very long range here, Kaka. The effectiveness of this Exorcism is very low because of it. I don't think they want to take any risks of any kind of jump-ins. So the tower goes away, the Death Prophet. Now putting her about 500 gold short of having a full heart, which is going to make it almost next to impossible to get a kill. She doesn't have enough damage coming out. This burst damage is nothing from VG Gaming up against a hardened Krob. 2.2k life points with potential to send yourself up into the air with the Yule Scepter. The upside, at least for VG Gaming, is the fact that she doesn't own a BKB. But they have to get their initiation perfect with a lot of follow-up. And until Black has something along the lines of a Basher or a Skadi, there won't be enough damage coming out from these cores of VG Gaming to bring down that Death Prophet. Later in the game, sure. Then again, later in the game, she's probably going to have a lot more armor than just 5 points. Super's playing around with Pretty Whore. There's also that other thing. You try and go in on the Death Prophet, and then all of a sudden, snowball protection. The Exorcism still does its work, so I think it's 5 seconds you can hold her in. Yep. Launch time, 4 seconds. That's basically 5 seconds of immunity, where the Exorcism just starts to work. And also drags it in closer while you're still immune. They gave a crack here at Ice. There should be a glimpse back moment. Yeah, she used the glimpse and almost dragged Ice. Yeah, look at the ping. It's like, please stop doing that. He almost dragged him back out of the chrono with that glimpse. Very lucky for him, he did not. Super, just rappel and TP out. No damage to him, he's fine. Top lane Black trying to force into the top tower. While ZSMJ, he's feeling very happy. BKB over on this Viper. Pretty Ore's already got a Blink Dagger with an Urn, so that Walrus Punch. Very, very simple for him to hit now. Even the Disruptor, how are we looking? Coming on the Courier, just an Ogre Club for now. But that means 1800 gold away from having his Aghanims. Leap away by Icy. That's the full Mystic Flare being used and had to use the Shadow Dance. Runs to the right, trying to keep him away, and then wants to pounce himself over the tree line. But Black, control for too long. The leap was still on cooldown for an extra second. Krob, she's waiting for she'll Yule's the Sky Wrath up. That's the easier kill. Super's hanging around with FY just in case. In fact, the rest of the team from HGT didn't get there in time because they did have to hang around a little bit longer to kill off Black. They weren't able to get there to help. Super standing and tanking up against the Illusions. Now he'll actually respond. And they realize that is actually a real one. And that means they jump. Is that diffuser blade somewhere? There's the Viper Strike. Polar Punch, pushing him up. Now you'll get a little bit of protection. But then diffuser blade sent up in towards the air. Ice, coming in from the side. But Super with the Crypt Swarm, he gets a purification off in time. Ice also able to TP out in time. Living life very much on the edge here, VG Gaming. Fenrir, in 8 seconds he can go for this epicenter. The fortification will buy him some time. He'll have to do it perfectly from the tree line. The Sigil is already trying to scout him out. And successful at doing so. Ice, hoof stomps up, but the Yule Scepter sends him up. The Chrono is looking for a good target. Can't find it perfect just yet, especially when he gets sealed up. Now, over onto FY as well as Ice. Locked in, the Snowball goes down to Super. It's not enough to kill up this Omni Knight, especially with the D-Gen Aura. He's trying to repel up Fenrir, but now Burrow Strike back up. Two to catch out. Still only Black on the sidelines at the moment. Now the SK will join him. Super sticking out to the Urn Charge. ZSMJ moving forward. That glimpse back the Sky Wrath Mage. ZSMJ, he will die right now, but still a double kill for him. The Snowball in, and they say it's over. HCT have won too many fights, and they will win this one and get themselves a date to play with LGD CDEC. I don't know if the match is up tomorrow, but either way, the lower bracket getting heavily stacked. We actually have, Magneto are the ones to drop down, but Invictus Gaming, Newbie, LGD, and now VG Gaming all find themselves being pushed down into the lower bracket. That is not what they are expecting to have happen to themselves. And two of those teams are already out, which is IG as well as LG, Newbie as well as LGD. So that's going to end our broadcast, at least for the Join Out of Red live stream today. I believe Join Out of Blue is still live and doing the Cena Cup, so head over to twitch.tv. No, it's not. Cap just poked his head through the door. So it looks like that game is already over. So we'll be back in a few hours' time. You can check out the live stream. You go to joinout.com and you'll find our D2CL live stream. So the match is going to be happening at 22:30. There is also potential ESL games coming up tonight. So keep your eyes peeled for that one. We might have ourselves some last-minute scheduling for that. So keep your eyes peeled on Join Out of Red. Of course, if you follow the channel, you get yourself an email notification. If you also subscribe to the channel, you have my thanks. And always watch joinout.com for the countdowns and the live streams. All right, thanks for watching, everyone. And we'll see you next time on the live stream.